Let's see, today, the Grouch Weather Program, followed by What's My Grouch, the Dinah Grouch Show, and the Best of Groucho. Oh, rats. Huh. You know what? All my favorite Grouch TV shows are on today, and my TV set is broken. Oh, I mean, I can get a picture, but you can't hear any sound. Now, how am I going to enjoy my favorite shows? Boy, I'd have to be able to read their lips to tell what they're saying. Hey, that gives me an idea. And look who's coming, too. Hey, oh, Oscar, you're so smart. Hey, come here. Linda, is it true you can tell what people are saying just by reading their lips? Yeah, you can't hear them, but you can see what they're saying by watching what words they're saying. Yeah, just like you're doing now with me. Terrific. If I say mama, what word is that? Right, mama. You don't have to hear, you can just watch my lips. How about the word milkshake? And you're shaking it. Hey, very good. How about a hard one like moldy mattresses? Hey, that's moldy and a mattress. Right. Hey, look, Linda. My TV set is broken. I can't hear it. But you could watch and tell me what they're saying, huh? Will you do that? Huh? You will? Oh, great. Now, it's a weather show I want to watch, see? But, maybe you better tell me what some of the signs are for some of the words so I'll know what you're telling me. Like, if he says, snow, what is snow? What's the sign you make? That's snow. Oh, yeah, like snow falling. Yeah, how about, rain? Rain. Yeah, rain. How about, thunder? Oh, I like that one. Let me see that one again. Thunder. Thunder again. Yeah. My favorite kind of weather. How about hurricanes? Wow, big wind, huh? Like that, wow. And how about beautiful, beautiful slush? Huh? Slush. Yeah, snow falls, gets all mushy. Yeah. Great, I'm in heaven. Hey, just in time, too, because look, I gotta turn on the set. Yeah. Time for the show. There. The Grouch Weather with Dr. Frank Freeze. This is good. Okay, now you watch and tell me what he says. There he is. Oh, what's he saying? What's the matter there? He's talking. Can't you read his lips? Huh? You mean you can't... The whiskers. You can't read his lips because his whiskers are in the way. Oh, no. Nothing ever goes right for me. Freeze, why don't you ever shave? Thanks anyway. Pooey!
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
W, X, Y, Z.
D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Is for basket and bandit and ball and various other things here on a wall, such as books and bananas and a bongo to beat, a bubble, a beetle, and biscuits to eat, and banjo and birdie and bottles of wine and boxes and berries all in a line. But B is for boy with a baseball and bat, who with one mighty blow knocks everything flat.
B is for bubble.
B is for bubble.
B is for bubble.
Bubble, bubble, bubble.
Bubble, bubble, bubble.
B is the bubble in bubble gum.
And B is your brother.
And B is better than any letter for bubble gum.
B is for bubble.
B is for bubble.
Bubble, bubble, bubble. Bubble, bubble, bubble. B is your bubble and bubble gum. And B is your brother who brought you some. And B is better than any letter for bubble gum.
B is the bubble and bubble. B is better than any letter for bubble gum.
Pow.
Hello. Oh, you got presents, everybody?
Yeah, I got mine.
Oh, that's good.
I got mine and David's and Lee's.
Ah.
Where's Big Bird?
Huh? Oh, I guess he must be wrapping his present.
He is?
Yeah.
Okay, well, here's what we should do, right? We'll hide the presents.
Mm-hmm.
So we can surprise Linda when she comes down the street, because today is her birthday. So here's how we should do it. I think we should just start playing a B-word game. And then when she comes down the street, I'll say, B is for birthday. And then we'll all make the sign for happy birthday.
Good. Good idea. Yeah, what's the sign for happy birthday?
All right, now watch. Happy.
Happy.
Birth.
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 Day.
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 Happy,
happy
birthday.
Day.
Everybody got it?
Yes.
Let's try it again. Happy birthday.
Good.
Okay?
Yes. All right.
Hold it. Wait. Here she comes.
We'll play that game. What are we talking about? You know the game.
Right.
How did we start?
B-word.
Yeah, B-word.
Hi, Linda.
How are you?
listen, we were just getting ready to play a word game, and can you play with us? You don't have time. Oh, well, wait, Melissa.
It'll just take a little while.
Just a little while. Okay, a little while. Okay. Oh, here's what we want you to do. You act out words that begin with the letter B, that start with the B sound, and we'll guess. Okay?
Balloon.
Oh, yes. Balloon. Yeah, good.
Bobber.
Bobber.
Big Bird.
Very good.
Bus.
That's a bus. That's a big word.
That's a B word. Yes.
Bus.
Bus.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. That's a B word.
Bye-bye.
Right.
Bye.
Another B word.
B-bye. Bye.
Bye. What?
Bye-bye. What? You forgot to give her the presents.
Right.
A boy named Jack took a letter B and planted it in the ground to see if the letter B would really grow. So he watered it, and what do you know? A bee stalk grew. It grew so high it disappeared up in the sky. Well, Jack climbed to the very top, and what he saw made him gasp and stop. For Jack had arrived at the land of B. It was big and beautiful, and Jack said, "Gee!"
Not G, it's B in our fair land, for things with B are really grand. We ride in buses, we ride on bikes, and bananas are the food that everyone likes.
What's that?
Our zoo, and you will see the animals' names all begin with B, like bears and buffaloes, birds and bees. Don't feed the animals, if you please. The games we play begin with B, too, like baseball and basketball, to name a few.
Oh, here's the B-stalk. I'd better get back before my mother calls. Oh, Jack! I've got to go. She's calling me. It was great to visit your land of B. Boy, that was fun. Oh, what a day. Wonder what would happen if I planted a K.
Riding out of the pages of history, Marshall Grover and his wonder horse, Fred.
Oh, that a boy, easy. Yeah. Oh, boy, am I tired and hot, and I am thirsty too, wonder horse Fred.
Well, Marshall, look up yonder there.
Where?
That there's a Short Branch Cafe.
Where?
No, over here.
Hmm? Oh!
Yeah, how's about you stop in and get yourself a nice cold glass of milk?
Oh, you are a wonder horse, Fred. Let us stop by and get a cold glass of milk. Okay, giddy up. Easy, boy. That's okay. You can make it.
Oh, frivolous Sal, she's my gal. Hey, boom, 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 boom. Oh no! Here comes Marshall Grover and his wonder horse Fred. Oh.
Okay, Fred.
Whoa, fella, please.
Whoa.
Watch out for the furniture over there, horse. Oh no!
Sorry about that.
Come on, please, Fred.
Whoa, come on.
Oh.
Good boy. Howdy, partner.
Howdy yourself.
I reckon I would like a glass of milk.
A glass of milk?
A glass of milk.
Well, tell me, would you like the big glass, the bigger glass, or the biggest glass?
The big glass, the bigger glass, or the biggest glass?
That's what I said. Uh-huh. Which would you like?
Let me see. That's a toughie. The big, bigger, biggest.
Should I tell him, Marshall?
Would you please?
He don't know the difference between big, bigger, and biggest.
The heck you say. Are you sure?
You got it from the horse's mouth.
Ooh, somehow I was sure you would say that. Well, Marshall, let me show you.
What?
Now, right here, we got a big glass of milk.
That is a big glass of milk.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then down here, right here, we got what you call your bigger glass of milk.
A bigger glass of milk.
You got that?
Mm, right
okay.
here.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
And then over here, heavy as all get out, is what you call your biggest glass of milk.
Wow, that is the biggest glass of milk.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you got the picture? Well, or would you like me to review it for you?
Would you please?
All right.
Thank you.
I'd be delighted to. Now, here you have your big glass of milk.
Mm-hmm.
Right here, you got your bigger glass of milk.
Mm-hmm.
And over here, you got your biggest glass of milk. And so which one would you like, please?
Well, that's a hard decision. Come on, Fred, let's go over and take
it
a quick look.
I'll
walk over there.
Hey, don't take the horse behind the bar for crying out loud.
Come on, okay, easy, ho, boy, ho.
Look what you did.
Let's see now. You certain that this here, partner, is the biggest glass of milk?
That's the biggest glass. If you want more milk than that, I'd have to bring in a whole cow.
Oh, would you do that, please?
No!
Well, you know, we got a horse in here. I just thought maybe...
Which glass of milk do you want?
I'm sorry, I will take the biggest, the biggest!
You want the biggest?
Yes, sir.
I thought you would. Go ahead.
Oh, I needed that. I was thirsty.
Can I get anything for the Wonder Horse over there?
No, thanks. I'm driving.
Good.
All righty. Well, thank you very much for the milk. And now, Fred, we must go off into the sunset. Okay, boy, giddy up.
Hey, wait a minute. Who's going to pay for all this stuff?
I'll be back tomorrow.
No, don't come back tomorrow.
Oh, yes, sir.
No,
tomorrow.
No, it's all right. It's all off. It's free. Bigger. Biggest.
Play a little game? I bet you'll never get the answer to these things. All about your face.
Right in the middle of my face, right in a very special place, is a thing that helps me sneeze and breathe as easy as I please. It helps me smell a pretty rose. What's it called?
Nose,
nose. Let me see your nose. Nose, nose, nose. I got a nose, oh yes I do, and so do you. Okay, you got that one, but you'll never get this one, because this is a really hard one. Above my nose, I'm sure you will agree, there are two things that help me see. I use them when I look at you, and you use yours to see me too. They help see birds and trees and skies. What are they called?
Right.
Eyes, eyes, eyes. I got two eyes, eyes. You sing with me. Eyes, eyes, eyes. And you've got two eyes, you've got... Now, you'll never get this one, because this is right really very, very hard. Right up above my chin, there is a thing I put food in. It helps me talk, it helps me chew, and then it helps me smile at you. From east to west and north to south, you know what it is? Right, mouth, mouth, mouth. I've got a mouth, mouth, mouth. I've got a mouth, oh yes I do. You know what else? And so do you, you, you. Everybody have a mouth? Open your mouth and say, wow!
Wow!
Okay.
bigger. Biggest.
There we go, my pyramid is finished. Hey, Bert, do me a favor. I want to take a picture of this pyramid I built, so while I get my camera, will you make sure nothing happens to the pyramid?
Oh, sure thing, Ernie.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. I just stand here and make sure nothing happens to Ernie's old pyramid.
Greetings. I am the Count.
Hi, Count.
Do you know why they call me the Count? Because I love to count things.
I know.
Ah, look. Blocks. I will count them.
Oh, wait. Those are my friend Ernie's blocks, and he told me...
Silence. I am counting. One. Two. Three. Four. No, I counted that one before. It is difficult to count these blocks in a pile.
Too bad, but you see, Ernie said...
I know what I will do. I will move each block as I count it.
Oh, no. Ernie asked me to...
One, two, three, four, five, six. Six blocks! Yes! Thank you very much.
Oh, boy. Did you see what the Count did? Before I could stop him, he took apart Ernie's pyramid. Oh, boy. I hope Ernie's not upset.
Oh, dear. I'm ready to take a picture of my... my pyramid.
Yeah.
What happened to it?
He's upset. Ernie, see, the Count was here, and while he counted your blocks, he took your pyramid apart.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
And you let him do it, Bert?
Well...
Greetings. I have decided to count these blocks again.
Now, hold on, Count. Now, these are Ernie's blocks, remember?
Yeah, you just leave those blocks alone.
Yeah,
you're not supposed to touch my blocks.
I am counting. One. Two, three, four, five, six, six blocks! Now, what did you want to say?
Ernie wanted to say that you should leave those blocks alone. You should leave things where you find them. Yeah, that's what he wanted to say.
Oh, did I move his blocks?
Yes, you did.
I am sorry. One, two, three, four, five, six, six blocks! Thank you very much.
Well, I sure told him a thing or two, didn't I, Ernie?
Yeah, but Bert...
I'm six. I'm six. I'm 6 years old today. Yay! I'm six years old today. I'm more than one. I'm more than two. I'm more than three. I'm much more than four. I'm even more than five. Can you guess how old I am?
This is quite a privilege to be on the surgical team of the world's most famous doctor.
It's like one of my dreams come true.
Shh! Here she comes.
Good morning, staff.
Good morning, doctor.
Now, this is a most important operation, and it is most important that I have the right tools. Now, when I ask you for a tool, I want you to be certain that you give me the right one immediately. Is that clear?
Yes, doctor. Yes, doctor.
All right. Let us begin. Wrench.
Wrench.
Pliers.
Liars.
Drill.
Drill.
Screwdriver.
Screwdriver. Well, Doctor, how is she?
The operation is a success. She's fine.
You mean we can?
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Oh, I can't wait to.
Hurry up.
Here we go.
Get on.
Here we go.
Let's sing a song of humbles, fa-la-la-loo, to tell us how many friends are in view.
Fa-la-la-loo, fa-la-la-lee,
this song's as easy as one, two, three.
Now I do the two for you and you. Yes, that is what I do.
But we could use a three.
For you and me.
Yes, let's use a three for you and me.
But what would you do if there were one more?
You and you and you
and me make four.
You
and you
and you
and me make four.
But what if someone else should then arrive?
In that case, we would use a five. If someone else like you should then arrive, you and you and you and you
and me
make five. For la la la, for la la la,
from five,
four,
three,
and one.
Thank you very much. You're too kind. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
One. Two. Three. Seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19.
What is going on?
There it comes.
20.
It's springtime. Leaves sprout and grass grows and birds start to sing. Walk in the park, take a ride on a swing in springtime. Then comes summer. Sun is hot, grass is green, there is no school. Bathing suits, lemonade, swim to get cool in summer. Then comes autumn. Red and gold leaves fall from trees every day. School starts and summer birds all fly away in autumn. Then comes winter. Snowmen and snowballs, cold hands and cold nose. bright frozen icicles, heavy warm clothes in winter. Then comes springtime, then summer, then autumn, then winter, and then it's springtime again.
All right, now this time we're going to go on six.
On six.
Come on, let's go.
Wait.
This way. Let's try this right now. Over here. There you are. Ready, set. One, two, three, four, five, six. Run, go get it.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Our race is just about ready to start. Yes, they're on the line, and now they start. Stop, stop. It's time to stop. And now for your halftime entertainment. Aren't they outstanding? And now it's time for more exciting race action to start. To start. Well, it's time to stop.
Hi there. How do you like my garden? Actually, it's just a window box here, and it's got a few things growing in it, mostly geraniums. Got some geraniums and a couple other little plants, and then I have some twiddle bugs growing in there, too. They're not flowers. They're actually things that live underneath the flowers. See the little house down there? That's the house where the twiddle bugs live. Isn't that cute? It's made out of a little milk carton, and it's got pencils there for the roof, and it's got a little drinking straw there. That's the chimney. And back behind it there, you see the fence there? That's made out of burned matches. And there's a clothesline there that goes across those two nails. And back on the other side there, see the paper clips there? That's a swing, where the kid poodle bugs swing. And out in front, that matchbox there, that's the family car. And it's got buttons for wheels. Isn't that sweet? Those are sweet little things, those twiddle bugs are. Oh, hey, I think I hear the twiddle bugs coming now. I wonder what they're doing today.
Oh, Daddy, are we really going to the zoo today?
Certainly, Tina, my dear. It's a beautiful day to go to the zoo.
Oh, dearie, dearie me, and heavens to my stars above. It certainly is a beautiful day. How are we going to get to the zoo, Daddy?
Well, I thought maybe we'd walk, Timmy.
Walk?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, goody, we'll walk.
Oh, gracious to goodness, Thomas, how far is the zoo from here? Well, Tessie, we just walked down Sesame Street.
Yes?
Turn left and keep on walking for about 3 days.
3 days?
Oh, Thomas.
Yes. I'll have to be back in Twitterbug school tomorrow, Daddy.
Oh, quite so, Tina, my girl. We cannot walk to the zoo. It would take too long. But how can we get to the zoo then?
Say, Daddy, at Twitterbug school yesterday, they taught us how to swim. How about we swim to the zoo?
Swim?
Swim?
My thanks to heavens to Betsy. Yes. We'll swim to the zoo. Let's go. Swim.
Swim. I'm doing a wrist roll.
Oh, good, Timmy.
Say, does anyone notice something strange about this?
Merciful wonder of my gracious sakes, yes. We're not getting wet.
We're not getting any closer to the zoo either. Do you suppose you need water to swim in?
Oh, it's possible, I suppose. Oh, gracious for merciness! There goes a little birdie flying by. That's it.
What?
We'll fly to the zoo.
Fly?
Yeah.
Oh, what a lovely idea.
Now everyone, flap your arms and we'll all fly up into the sky. Here we go. Sounds crazy, but maybe so. take this in. Here we go. Here we go.
Give him a card, Citizen.
Call Citizen.
I hope the officer in blue.
Cool. There go the Toodlebugs. Oh, what smart little rascals they are.
I deliver mail by horseback,
deep in the Appalachian Mountains off Kentucky. The roads is rough. You can't get through it without walking or going horseback. And it's too far to walk, and I ride a horse. People wait for me. They know the days I'm coming, and they all glad to see me come, get their mail. Top post office is too far away for him to walk and get it. I carry the mail Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Winter, spring, summer, and fall. Sometimes I give children short rides on the road as I go along. And then I have to go on. It's a long mail route, 18 miles through these mountains. I have a long ways yet to go.
It's an insult, I tell you. Look, I'm a fly. Fly begins with this letter, F. Trouble is, frog begins with F, too. But while flies are very handsome, frogs are fat and ugly. Therefore, I claim it's beneath my dignity as a fly to have to appear here to talk about the letter F with this...
Ribbit.
Okay, we got all the presents here.
All the presents. All
right, here. Now, Linda's bus should be along any minute now, and she's really going to be surprised, because she doesn't know that we know it's her birthday.
Right,
That's going to really surprise her.
I wonder where Big Bird is.
Hey,
I
guess he's...
Oh, here he is.
Hey,
oh,
look, no. I got a neat present for Linda.
What'd you get?
Let me just put it around here. Sorry, I didn't mean to step on you. Let me just park it over here. Whoops. Yes, would you help me put it in a good place?
Yes.
There.
That's good.
Now take a look at that.
What is that?
How do you like that, huh?
What'd you get, Big Bird?
Well, I got her something she's really gonna like. A phonograph, see? It even has a phonograph record on it and a little separate speaker. She can dance to it and everything.
Big Bird, gee, I don't know how to tell you this, but
I don't know if Linda can use a record player.
Why not?
Well, you see, Big Bird, Linda can't hear. And you see, she won't be able to hear the music.
Oh, no. I didn't even think of that. Oh, boy. And I kept thinking this was a perfect present for Linda. Oh, no. Well, what can you give to somebody who can't even hear anything?
Big Bird, don't be unhappy. Anything. Next time you'll know better.
You can give her anything, Big Bird, because except for her hearing, she's just like you and
sure,
me.
Sure, sure. She sees just like we do. That's why Susan and I gave her a book.
A book.
And feels like we do. That's why I got her a nice soft scarf.
And she can smell like, you know, like we smell things. So I got her some perfume, and she can taste things. And David and we sent her some chocolates.
Oh, those are all good ideas. And what did the silly old bird do? I bought her a phono. She can't even hear it.
Well, Big Bird, don't do
it. Oh, I'm sure she'll like it.
She's gonna laugh when she sees that.
Oh, there's the bus.
Let's get the bus.
Quick.
Yeah,
all
right?
Don't forget the sign.
Oh, the sign.
We learned a new sign today. We want to show it to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Linda.
Yeah.
For you.
Yeah. Open the presents.
Who takes that?
Open.
Yeah, see? It's a scarf.
Yeah.
A great idea.
Nice. Good.
She loves it.
Happy birthday from Susan and me.
Yeah, she's gonna like this one, too.
Yeah, I hope you haven't read it yet.
She likes it.
Good.
Oh, I feel the fool. What?
Smell good?
It does. She loves it. Oh.
Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Oh, it's some more.
And David and we sent that.
Yummy chocolates.
Tastes good.
She likes it too.
How is it?
Yes.
There's only one thing left. My silly present.
Oh, Big Bird, you don't
have
to feel bad.
Yeah, it's easy for you to say. Don't even look at it, Linda. Forget it. Oh, this is terrible.
So thank you, Big Bird.
Thank you?
Yeah.
You mean she likes it?
Yeah.
Yeah, she likes it.
But how can she enjoy the phono if she can't hear it?
Well, what do you know? By putting her hand on the speaker, she can feel the music, Big Bird.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can
feel
the
vibration.
Music. You can feel the vibration.
Oh, yeah?
Right.
Oh, well, maybe you like to dance. You mean you like it? Hey, she can dance, too.
From the land of Forp. Everyone there loves the letter F, because the letter F is fun. The letter F can go fast. And it can be fat. It can be furry. Or it can be flat. Or it can have flowers. can a fairy. Farewell.
I've thought a lot about a thought. I've thought about thinking. Thought about it a lot. I've thought some more. And do you know what? I think I've thought a thought. This thought is very small. How many small things can you think of? How about a flea? An ant? A grain of sand? Or a pin? A ladybug is small. So is a pebble. And a speck of dust is very small. A blade of grass. Or a gumdrop. Let's see, what else is small?
How about a sea monster?
You're not small. You're big.
I am too small. My daddy's big.
Did you ever think about all the great things you can do with your mind? Boy, it's really great. For instance, right now, I'm planning on walking through this door. Now, I haven't actually done it yet, but I'm thinking about how I'm going to come over here and open the doorknob, walk through the door. So I'm planning on it. Somebody's knocking at the door. Now, I don't know who's knocking at the door, but I can imagine. That's another thing you can do with your mind. Imagine. Yeah, for instance, I can imagine that my mother is knocking at the door. Now, I don't know that that's true, but I can imagine that my mother's knocking at the door. Wait a minute, I just remembered something. Yeah. That's another thing you can do with your mind. Remember. Yeah. Now, let's see. Mom told me that she was going to visit Aunt Mildred this afternoon. She told me that this morning, but I can still remember it now. So I don't know who's that knocking at the door. But let's go back to imagining. Yeah. I know. Yeah, I can imagine that there's a big scary monster knocking at the door. Oh, I can imagine that there's a big, scary, ugly monster knocking at the door. Let's talk about hoping. Let's see. Yeah, hoping's another thing you can do with your mind. And I sure hope that's not a monster. I can imagine that it's a monster, but I sure hope it isn't. Well, I'm not imagining anymore, and I'm not hoping, and I'm not remembering. Now I'm planning again. I'm planning to run!
I just wanted to know if you could come and play with my dollies and me. Oh, well.
Can you find an elephant in this picture? That's not an elephant. No, that's not an elephant either. Not an elephant. That's not an elephant. There's the elephant.
A boy named Jack took a letter B and planted it in the ground to see if the letter B would really grow. So he watered it, and what do you know? A B-stalk grew. It grew so high it disappeared up in the sky. Well, Jack climbed to the very top, and what he saw made him gasp and stop. For Jack had arrived at the land of B. It was big and beautiful, and Jack said, "Gee!"
"Not G, it's B in our fair land, for things with B are really grand. We ride in buses, we ride on bikes, and bananas are the food that everyone likes."
"What's that?"
"Our zoo, and you will see the animals' names all begin with B, like bears and buffaloes, birds and bees. Don't feed the animals, if you please. The games we play begin with B, too, like baseball and basketball, to name a few."
"Oh, here's the B-stalk. I'd better get back before my mother calls."
"Oh, Jack!"
"I've got to go. She's calling me. It was great to visit your land of bee. Boy, that was fun. Oh, what a day. Wonder what would happen if I planted a K."
"Want to dance? Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters B and F, and by the old number 6. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.